For more on the Munich case, I'm joined via Skype by Wall Street Journal reporter Anton Troianovski. Anton, tell us, what are the authorities saying happened, the sequence of events? How did it get to this space outside the McDonald's in the first place?
Well, what we know for sure is that shooting at the McDonald's started at about 5:50 p.m. last night. The gunman then moved outside the McDonald's onto the street and then eventually inside the shopping center across the street. That was at about 6 p.m. local time. 2.5 hours later, 8:30 p.m., the gunman was sighted by some officers on patrol nearby. The officers called out to him at that point. The police now say the gunman put his gun to his head and pulled the trigger.
All right, so there are some reports that he had hacked someone's Facebook account. What is this about?
That's right. So at around 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon, a post appeared on a young woman's Facebook page in Munich, inviting people to come to that McDonald's about an hour later, and that she would buy people free food, or buy people food as long as it wasn't too expensive, she said. The authorities are now saying they believe that the gunman actually hacked that account as a way of luring people into the McDonald's.
Wow. What do we know? What more do we know about the shooter or his family? I'm sure that lots of investigations are going on right now, but how were they able to rule out that there are no ties to Islamic terrorism?
Well, you can obviously never rule that out, but the police are saying at this point they have absolutely no evidence to indicate ties to any kind of international terrorist organization. The man was an 18-year-old named Ali David Sonboli, a dual Iranian-German citizen. He was born in Munich. His parents came to Germany from Iran in the late 1990s. And as far as a motive goes, the best police have been able to come up with is, as you mentioned, a lot of evidence in his bedroom at home that he was obsessed with mass killings. And one potential motivation for the crime occurring on Friday is that it was the 5-year anniversary of the Breivik massacre in Norway that killed 77 people. And that was one of the mass shootings that this young man had clearly taken an interest in, according to some documents and social media posts of his that the police have been able to track down.
Is there anything about his personality that fits kind of the stereotypes or the MO that we have of people who do this?
Well, certainly, you know, we've talked to people who knew him today and heard some of those tropes that you often hear about mass shooters or, for example, school shooters in the United States, that he was someone who often seemed to be alone, played violent video games. At this point, police are still very much scratching their heads, as are people who knew this man, as to what exactly brought him to do it. Another thing that police have said today is that they believe that the man was in psychiatric treatment, that he potentially was being treated for depression. But those are all still very preliminary conclusions that the police are still investigating.
All right, Anton Troianovski of the Wall Street Journal joining us via Skype today. Thanks so much.
Thank you.